I think at the core of it, we don't have a culture any different from what I experienced at Google, and to some extent even at Adobe. I think both these companies allowed a lot of freedom for the employees to do things they enjoy doing while at the work, and you know, provide the same career growth that they, you know, really want in their career. So have that freedom of choice and expression. I think at the core, InMobi as a company enjoys the same values. So it's been pretty exciting 4 months being here, having that the same feel, but working for a much smaller startup in a very exciting phase of the company. So we have an office back in Bangalore, which is our headquarters, global headquarters. Mm-hmm. So our engineering, data center, NetOps, product, all these functions run out of there. The founders sit all in Bangalore, and we have a remote office here in Singapore to run the region. See, at the heart of it, we are a technology company which does mobile advertising as a business. So we are a mobile ad network with a global business, presence in almost every continent globally. And essentially what we do is we help advertisers reach out to the audience that they want to on mobile as a medium. And the way we do that is we work with partners who have audience on their websites and applications and connect them and that intelligence to the advertisers in the ecosystem. So we work with stakeholders across the entire value chain in mobile ecosystem. So we work with telecom operators, we work with the publishers who have these mobile websites. Developers are a very important component of the ecosystem. We work with developers who make these games and applications. So this is the supply side, you know, which is where users go and consume mobile as a medium. On the other side, we have agencies, we have direct brand advertisers who want to reach out to this audience. So InMobi is something that stays in the middle and provide the advertisers, the users that they want to reach out to, while helping these publishers and developers make money from the traffic that they have on their websites and applications. I think in the short to medium term, you will see us doing a lot more of what we have been doing in the last 1 year, which is two things. One, increasing our global reach and footprint. We already have presence in every continent, every geo. We don't have a field office in China and Korea as yet, but that is something we plan to do this year. We don't have an office in Latin America as of now, although we do business and we have teams focusing on that market. So we will invest more in Latin America and have a field presence there. So one is this global footprint is what we should expect. Mm-hmm. Second thing is, one of the main ingredients of InMobi's success as we see it is investment in technology and products. And I think we'll do even more of that going forward. So you'll see us investing a lot in technology and products to help us understand the users a lot better, which will improve the ecosystem that we are building here. I think one thing that we have seen change over the last 7-8 months to 1 year is the device prices are coming down very, very fast. You know, when the first Android came, which was G1 3 years back, and you know, all the series of phones that you have seen after that have been at a very steep price point. Now, with the price of components coming down, whether it is a touchscreen or a Wi-Fi module or 3G module, consumers can now experience a touchscreen Wi-Fi 3G phone at something in the ballpark of $100 to $150. And what that has led to is a lot more engagement is possible with the users on these better devices. The way it manifests in the ecosystem is that you can do very smart, very meaningful, very engaging conversations with the customers, which was not possible before. So that is one thing. Second is, the agencies and the clients were not really aware of mobile as a medium and its capabilities till like 1.5 years back, 1 year back. But now those conversations are changing. From getting a conversation like, you know, what is the value of mobile? What is it that we can do on mobile? Now they're not asking those questions. They're asking questions like, how can I do this on mobile? How can I do even more of what I'm doing on mobile? How can you help us to reach this audience and sell this product and convey this? So I think the whole DNA of the ecosystem is changing, and this is a very exciting time for us. I think there is hardly any country untouched by the mobile revolution. just to give you a statistic, we have about 110 countries on our network where we do at least 10 million impressions a month. That's significant.
Yeah.
So we're not seeing any country left untouched, but different countries have different evolution, the journey in their evolution. So markets, for example, Singapore, are very, very high-end centric. Almost all the consumers here consume high-end phones like iPhones and Androids and Blackberries. Whereas in other markets like Indonesia or India, you have a wide spectrum of devices that people have. Starting from low-end Nokia phones, to mid-range Nokia phones, to all the other OEMs from China and Taiwan and India, giving phones at sub-$100, to going to as high up as tablets and Android phones and iPhones. We believe tablet as a mobile device is going to be an integral part of how people consume mobile as a medium. And what we are doing is we are extending the lead that we have on mobile ecosystem to tablet ecosystem. And in Barcelona, in fact, 1.5 months back, we launched 3D advertising with a partner, Cool Iris, where brands can now engage with audiences for the first time in a 3D ad format. Very, very rich and engaging experience for the brand.